Let's take the big boys off the line in Ottawa. First MX-1 Moto, unless he hole shots, and he goes wire to wire, winning the first MX-1 Moto. Second Moto off the gate. Brownie shots! Benaglia gets into the lead, but it turned into the Colton Fasciotti-Alessi show. Unless he loses some grip, Fasciotti takes the win with a big booter and tops the box in Ottawa. Welcome, race fans, to round 7 of the 2014 Rockstar Energy Drink Motocross Nationals. Mark Travers and Brian Koster in the booth as we look at a very damp motocross, the Deschambeau, just outside of Quebec City. Our MX-1 class racing today will be brought to you by Motovan.com, the source for power sports parts and accessories. MX-1 bikes coming out of staging, Brian. Very interesting start to the day with the track conditions.
The rain came down in biblical proportions this morning. It just soaked the place. So qualifying was very dicey. Josh Hill got the fast time. Dylan Kalin, second fast right there. Quite impressive.
Babs, let's get to our points in the MX-1 class. After 6 of 10, of course, Fasciotti holding court. Alessi in second. Medaglia distant third. Mayer Hill. Interesting as we head down into the bottom five.
Kyle Chisholm slowly working his way up, catching up a little bit to Hill. Bobby Canary's holding down seventh pretty well. Dylan Kalin inching his way forward. Berger and Gasson right there.
MX-1 pilots getting their gate ready. Not as much preparation to the bike and rider from mud today, Brian. Maybe because of the sand, you think?
Yeah, for sure. Not the foam and all the accoutrements that go with it, but they will definitely spray the bikes down with like the anti-stick spray, similar to what you'd use at home, called PAM.
Babs, let's have a look at today's track, but before we do that, a couple of sights and scenes from this morning when that rain was coming down. I thought it was never going to stop. It's a good thing this track is sand-based, though, because it's been able to accept the amount of water. They've been pushing a lot of the slop off to the side, and it's got quite a hard base.
And you know, with this deep sand here, it rarely gets muddy. So when there's puddles like this, you know how hard it rained. Mostly beautiful sand here, big elevation changes, a wide track over in the other treed section, black dirt, a little muddier over there. Big news for the weekend, though, is Mike Alessi's little brother, Jeff, there on the 801, has joined the party and lined right up beside Colton. Dynamic action next.
Welcome back to round 7 of the 2014 Rockstar Energy Drink Motocross Nationals. Hey, race fans, don't forget about the CMRC MX page on Facebook. Like it, mxnationals.ca. That's where all the goodness is. Moto board coming across. Sweet Dasha with the 30 board up. And Sir Paul from Rolton, England, overseeing the proceedings.
I'd say Kingsley's got the best seat of the house right next to the Russian beauty. This Moto Travs will be brought to you by Yoshimura Performance Exhaust. That's the pipe you want on your bike.
I know it's one of your favorites, Fabs. Okay, that board has gone to 5. MX-1 riders now focusing on the gate 5 sideways. A very short sandy straightaway into that big left-hander, Brian. Let's go on board with David Gasson.
Gasson on the Devil's Lake MX Yamaha teammate right in front of him, but it's Bobby Canary, rock star Yamaha. And that is the Ocean Transportation YZ450 with a shot.
A lot of roost out there. Gasson getting covered as the boys funnel through this double section and come into this dynamic roller section. All right, a very wide part of the track. We have a rider down, and that is young Colton Fasciotti, series points leader.
Holy smokes, it really funnels into that tight, tight left-hander. A few deep ruts on the inside. Riders get hung right up. We'll hope for a replay.
Oh, look at that. Oh, boy. He comes out of the corner and locks horns with 801. That's Jeff Alessi. Very interesting start.
Yeah, Jeff Alessi up here having fun racing in Canada, supporting his brother. We'll see if he can get in Colton's face. He's got the inside line. He's going to come up this hill. No, Colton gets by.
Jeff Alessi's got a bit of a history, Brian. They come up here. We're not sure what to think right now. It's a race, and we have a track. The number 2 of Bobby Canary is in the lead. Josh Hill is in second. Medaglia in third. Alessi in fourth. That's Mike Alessi. Bit of a freight train right now.
Usual suspects up front. In fifth is Kyle Chisholm, Bobby's teammate, to a replay of the start. Boys jostling around. Bobby's got it. Wow. Medaglia on the outside. Hill comes right up into the point position. Holy smokes. Chisholm there just around 10th. Now here's where it all goes wrong for Fat Yotes around the outside. There's a bit of a big rut there. He looks ahead, gets a little checked up from some other riders, and just falls down seemingly on his own. Rest of the pack comes in and makes life difficult for him.
And here's that little connection that he had with Jeff Alessi coming around the corner. I mean, let's face it right now, Brian, let's watch this. If Alessi wanted to take him out, that was the opportunity, and he did not. clean racing right there. I like that.
Jeff Alesi up here for all the right reasons. He wants to be back into racing. Had some difficulty south of the border. Great to have him up here. Look at that slop in the middle. You got to go inside, outside. What a pass for Tyler Medaglia. Wow.
Medaglia using one of the widest parts and one of the sloppiest parts of the track to carry momentum. Hill goes inside. That's a tough corner, Brian. It was real juicy early this morning.
Hill is traditionally an outside kind of sweeping rider. I think he figured, hey, the pack's coming. I better get on the inside for defense and damage control. Tyler just got on it hard on the outside. Tyler riding great right now. Bobby pulling away out front. We know when Bobby gets a hole shot drafts, he's got the ability to check out.
Well, and talk about hole shots. Bobby Canary has become the king of hole shots in this country. He is the best starter, period, right now. And that Bondi-Engie Yamaha is lightning fast. The 311 of Mike Brown, former MX champion, down south of the border. Nathan Bless, another good start. Mare, and here comes Bastiati.
Bastiati looked like making a little bit of an adjustment there on his clutch. Oh, rider down right in front of him. That is the number five of Teddy Mayer. Very uncustomary. We don't see Teddy crash in motos very often. He is the model of consistency.
Bastiati on the outside through that double section. Looks like he might have the Dutchman Bless. Oh, Bless having a hard time with that inside line. The one thing, Brian, is that the way the track is set up right now, a little one line, and I think that inside line is by far the most difficult because of the excavation.
Yeah, these bikes that just dig deeper and deeper, and you can get a bit of a ledge or a layer of hard dirt. It's easy to get cross rutted. Round the outside now, Hill making another charge on that C4 MX bike. His mechanic, Luke Couette, who is known as Frenchie, owns C4 MX and builds those motors for the team. He's got to be on the edge of the fence right now in the mechanics area, pulling hard for his rider.
Hill is carrying a ton of speed. We just saw him use that outside line. You mentioned that. He had the fastest qualifying time. Wow, he looks like he is all about it today.
And you take a rider, you know,
my goodness. Tyler doing everything that he can do to stay on the track, Brian. That is a very slippery corner, that Cowie corner.
Small mistake for Tyler, back in the hunt, back to Hill. Originally from Oregon, living in California. These guys not normally known as mud riders. He's showing really well. A little bit of smoke, though, coming out of the bottom of the bike.
He's got mad skills, fast. Forget about it. Back to the 311. Mike Brown up here on the Husqvarna. Love having him here. Bastiati carrying speed, doing exactly what he had to do. Auger was out.
And Colton's sitting way back, getting traction. Here's Tyler coming in. He knows he's battling right now hard with Hill. Gets right into the meat of the berm and just steps over, does a little paddling action. And Josh Hill struggling, having his own struggles, makes the pass.
Tyler Medaglia does not have goggles on either, Brian, so that's an interesting point. To our leader, the number two of Bobby Canary, coming out of that trade session, looking really good. Nice gap back to Hill in second place. And it looks like the battle right now is going to be for third place. That's Medaglia in third, and the number 800 of Mike Alesi, so he's starting to make up some time.
Alesi finished fourth in the mud in Regina, and remember, that's the race Medaglia got second in, so we know Tyler Medaglia has mad mud riding skills, and good observation without goggles. This track is more sand, so you're going to get that sand in the eyes, not quite as dangerous as all the little rocks, but nonetheless bothersome. It's hard to see, and your eyes are getting packed in, not only from roost, but stuff coming up off your own front wheel. So Tyler right now may have to come into the pits for goggles.
A lot of moisture out there too. You can think about condensation on the inside of the goggles with the heat and the sweat. So a very difficult situation with or without goggles, unless he's carrying speed. Tyler, I like that defense little hack off.
See, the lap rider in the middle could barely even get through that slop. So it's important these guys stay on the designated dry line. Rider going wide, getting out of the way. And now Alesi has made it stick on the number three.
Sometimes in a situation like this, Brian, in a moto, you gotta let a pass happen because you don't want to get yourself in a position where you go down.
Oh, for sure. You don't go off track here. Big, deep ledges. You're in the forest. It's deep, deep rhubarb. So you gotta stay up on the racing surface. Bobby Canary right now out front, just having it all his own way. Looking super stylish, rock star gear. Guy looks great on the bike.
His teammate, the 732 of Kyle Chisholm, now working his way up to the three of Tyler Medaglia. Talking about Canary, he looks fantastic out there. He's clean, he's neat, he gets the whole shot, but his bike is smoking right now. Maybe a little heat on the
condensation here.
Oh no, Fabs, total lockup.
Oh my gosh, he's not even trying to start it. He felt it. These guys have been around long enough that they know when it's catastrophic. That was just that. Totally catastrophic, locked up in the air. Tyler Maligno goes by teammate Chisholm, alias Gear. Looks great. Looks a heck of a lot better when you're actually rolling on the bike.
Referee Daryl Murphy out taking care of the business. I'd love to see that man out on the track. Colton Fasciati now getting by.
This is damage control for Colton. After lying down on the start, he's worked his way all the way up into the top five. So he is doing what he needs to do, consistently scoring points for the championship.
The battle right now is for the lead. Kinnaird out, Hill in the lead, Alessi in second place, and he has closed the gap.
And see how slow they got to go through those deep ruts. Here it is again. A little bit of smoke. We thought, hey, maybe he just went through a little puddle, and it just seizes up right there. Bobby's legs out. All he can do is nothing.
You're right. Furious goggles up. He knows that his moto is over. To the three of Tyler Medaglia sitting right now in third place. No goggles. Boy, he's been a warrior in this moto. Chisholm. Fasciati has gotten by Chisholm. Last lap flag, there is Chisholm.
Wow, Chisholm must have had a little issue. Colton made a lot up there, so Chisholm in fifth. Here comes Hill for his first win in Canada. I want to talk about Tyler Medaglia. Just so much heart. Love that kid. He's staying focused. He's going to get on the podium. But Josh Hill is taking the glory. Bobby Cannavale retired. A nice gift for Josh. He'll take it any way he can get it, man. And a win is a win out here in Canada. Outdoor motocross, known for his supercross skills. Looks back. This is huge. What a win for the likable young man out of the United States of America.
First win for that Monster Energy team in a class that they've dominated for the last 2 years. Welcome back to Motocross Deschambeau. First MX1 moto in the books. Alessi and Hill on the podium. Let's get to our top 10. Tyler Medaglia salvaging third. Colton Fasciati fourth. Chisholm, Mayer, Mike Brown, Kyle Keith. Jeff Alessi finishes ninth. And Zeb Dennis, tenth. Let's go to the impound with the Greyhound. Galdi.
He was waiting. Fans were waiting. But now he made it happen here in Deschambeau, round number 7. Monster Energy Thor Kawasaki. Josh Hill, buddy. Didn't get the start up front. Had to battle a little bit. Made you work for it. But once you got there, dude, there was no turning back.
Yeah, I got a good start, but I got stuck a little bit down in the bottom, and Medaglia got around me, and then I kind of just had to go to work on him, and we had a pretty good battle. But, man, I was pumped. We got a good start on the Monster Energy Thor Kawasaki, and you know, I've been waiting to win one of these things. I thought I had it in me, and finally did it in some pretty tough conditions.
I'm going to call this guy the soldier in that moto once again. Losing the goggles, Tyler, but yeah, you hung on again, and Yotes was all over you at the end, but there was no way you were giving that third spot up.
Yeah, no way. I mean, I felt good the last little bit. I made a dumb mistake. I put my goggles in a Ziploc bag before the race, and when I went to put them on before the start, they were all fogged up. So, and they got worse as the race went on, as I got hot. So, a little bit of a bummer. I mean, the lappers are just killing me out there today. Like, man, they were racing with me. Sometimes I just wanted to pull a Mike LaRocco and swat them back in the back of the head, but I'm happy with the bike's working good, so I just gotta get a good start in the next race.
MX1 boys on the line. Blue Sky's coming out. Second moto next. Welcome back to Motocross Deschambeau in round 7 of the 2014 Rockstar Energy Drink Motocross Nationals. The lovely Melissa bringing that moto 2 board across. Riders on the line. Nice little fist pump with Alessi and the number 93. This second MX1 moto will be brought to you by Couche Tard. Fabulous place to get all your goodies. Ice cold Rockstar. And there's the exquisite Rockstar Dasha. 30 board up. Dynamite style. She might want to put that board in front of Sir Paul.
For a guy that's never at a loss for words, Dasha leaves me stumbling, and it goes to five. Kingsley synchronizes the watch, Travers.
Riders now focusing on the gate. Five sideways, gate is down, Brian. Coming into that short left-hander. Who's going to get that roll? The street hole shot.
Oh, is Bobby going for it? Oh, my goodness, I can't even call that.
Photo finish. I think they're giving it to the number 45. That's the GDR Honda of Colton Fasciati. Bobby Canary, oh, behind by Anabi, and then Mike Alessi, our top three pilots right now. Well, in terms of speed, up in the mix. And how about the 801 of Jeff Alessi?
Bumping and grinding, Zeb Dennis right in there. And if Bobby had gotten that hole shot, that would have been the triple crown. So loses out by Anabi. So Fasciati out front. This is what he needs. Let's see if he can check out on the field.
On board with the 31 Devil's Lake Yamaha of Dylan Kalin. Some great visuals with this drift action cam down into those soupy valleys. Now this is the part of the track we haven't seen before, Brian. Elevation from top to bottom. Trees all over the place. Gorgeous.
Nice creative lines there for Dylan Kalin. These drift action cams just offering spectacular imagery. Get some good sound too of the motorcycles. Bobby Canary kind of having a peek around Alessi getting out of the roof. So Trav's track actually setting up pretty nice now, drying out a bit.
Going up in that tree section, Canary was actually ahead of Alessi. Alessi got by him. Did you see how bold that move was? There was no question that Bobby K was taking that inside line.
That's the New Yorker coming out of him, man. He is one tough customer. He's been racing a long time. He's been racing and battling Alessi in Supercross for years. He don't take no guff. And he plays for keeps.
There's no question about Canary's speed, though. That's the one thing for sure. Guys, we go back on board the 31 of Dylan Kalin. You can see how deep those ruts are on the inside of this corner. The number 20 of Nathan Bless right ahead of him, who's been a real bright light in this Eastern Series. Chisholm with the wide line. This track is really setting up. Nice pad. Let's go back to the start detail at Pools.
Well, here they come. Top three guys right there. Alessi has to check up a bit. A little scrubber with Kalin. Look at the body English on Alessi. Colton Fasciati tucks right in there. The guys on the outside look like they're getting the hole shot. Canary clips the track marker, but the guy that tucks in gets the hole shot, and that's Flat Yokes.
And some great English from Alessi off of that jump face to stay in third. And let's go back to that pass for Bobby K. Fabs is on the wide side, gathers up the throttle, comes in like 90, and says, I'm taking that lap.
Alessi thinks he's got it, but look at the quick movements for Alessi to the outside. Says, you want to go there? I'll just rail around the outside, try my luck. You do not want to follow. Look at this, out of the trees. Alessi comes in with a very aggressive move on Canary. You see him bust that berm. Travs, holy smokes, these guys are going at it. Tooth and nail.
And Alessi passed Canary on lap number one in that exact same spot. So maybe he backed off saying, don't worry about it, BK. I got you. Next lap.
And they are very close to Fasciati. Really, like, look at this. Alessi, we've seen him charge and catch and pass Colton at other races. We'll see what he can do now. He's just a couple seconds outside of the lead.
Some Southern Ontario stars making their way in Quebec. That's the 713 Moto Park Yamaha Zeb Dennis and the 20 KTM of Nathan Bless. Brownie's in the mix, and here comes Josh Hill. What? Oh no! Bobby K has stalled the bike.
Oh my goodness, let's hope that's all it is. Yes, he's trying to get it fired up. And back to our first Moto winner, Hill. Not a great start. These two, big lockup for Medallia coming in. Oh, and then a bit of a flying W hits that kicker coming out of the turn. These deep ruts, very taxing and challenging. This is just a game of correction, overcorrection, correction, slip and slide and roost, and there's so much going on.
Well, I think defense is the name of the game today. Great English from Alessi over that jump. You're right, he's keeping cold on us. I think if you're too aggressive, things can happen.
Exactly, you can easily crash. We've seen it time and time again. These riders really gotta maintain focus. Look at this, drag racing, grabbing tear-offs. This is awesome battling throughout the pack. Crowds gotta love the Deschambault layout. Great crowd, great place to be on a Sunday afternoon.
That was the 311 Husqvarna on Mike Brown. Outside to inside, gets by Dennis. Looks like Hill has gotten by Bless. Jeff Alessi's in this mix, as well as Chisholm. So a nice little package inside the top 10.
Great to not only have Jeff Alessi up here, but Mike Brown, the 311, an icon of U.S. motocross, a previous 125 U.S. national champion, multi-time factory rider. And they are dicing hard for eighth position. Hill makes the move, going up. Zep Dennis dives in, but Hill takes it.
Back to the battle for third place. Two former MX2 champions in this country, the number five of Teddy Mayer, Monster Energy Kawasaki. and the number three Red Bull KTM of Tyler Medaglia. Medaglia looking good. Oh, a little brake check from there and some evasive maneuvering for the number three.
These two come together so much on track, they might as well just move in together, for crying out loud. They're always dicing. They're always in each other's grill. Number three, number five, but a nice move there on the inside. Tyler stretches it out a bit.
Tyler up to third, Mayer back to fourth. Here comes our leader, 45, Colton Passiotti. Let's watch him through this rhythm section, Brian. Looking gorgeous.
This rhythm section is so wide. There's a split line there so you can pick your poison, so to speak. Just correcting and overcorrecting. Brownie, Husqvarna, expiration date is up for that motor.
Issues for Brownie in the Motul corner. Let's get back to the 175 of Josh Hill, who is putting on a clinic. The French fans love him, Brian. Maybe it's that style. Look at him go. He's on the mic. He's off the mic. Looking for those wide lines. He's got one.
Oh, my goodness. Chisholm, a Florida suspicious. Oh, he could have just taken the line away from Hill. Very respectful riding from Kyle Chisholm. But now, the number five, Monster Thor Kawasaki rider Teddy Mayer, has got his teammate behind him and a hard-charging Chisholm. So with Medaglia pulling away a little bit on Mayer, Mayer has got to get back into overdrive.
Wow, look at how deep those ruts are coming out of the Kawasaki corner. That's our leader, the number 45, Gopher Dudes Racing Honda, Colton Passiotti, with a nice gap over Mike Alessi. Back to Jeff Alessi on the 801, sitting in ninth place. Dylan Kalen, 31 and 10th. Oh, as we go on board, and Kalen takes care of that inside line and takes care of Jeff Alessi.
Solid motowing from Dylan Kalen, Devil's Lake MX rider. Team's out of Alberta, he's from Ontario. Really coming into his own this year, challenging with other bright lights like Nathan Bless, but it is Hill aggressing right now as this track dries up, Travis. It's getting faster and faster. They're coming into these turns and carrying the outside. We know Hill loves that.
Oh, that outside line was working for him. You just tell the English that he had that he was gonna carry speed, although that outside line's getting rough as well.
Hill loves to just flow around the tracks. Very mentally calm, and I think that's why he's strong at the end of these races. He doesn't really get too flustered, just lets the bike work under him. He rides in the middle of the bike and just lets the bike do its thing, maybe using less energy than some of his competitors.
Babs, a nice little mid-track cluster. We've got the 7 of Morgan Berger, the 713 of Zeb Dennis, and the number 20 of Nathan Bless. Wow, carrying speed. That part of the track really sucks the horsepower out of the bike, even on these big 450s.
You can just tell by how slow they're going that it's a lot gnarlier than we can really see here on camera. Number 3, Tyler Medaglia, who showed up so well in the first moto, finishing 3rd, going down for a pair of 3s today.
Medaglia getting his last lap flag, back to the number 175 of Josh Hill coming up. Rutted jump faces too late in the day, Brian. Hill getting his last lap flag. Here is our leader, final approach, Gopher Dunes Honda, Colton Passiotti, red plate, leading this class.
He has just gapped Alessi by some 30 seconds. Alessi was there earlier on, and Colton just put on the afterburners and has checked out. Huge for his confidence, hugging the insides, coming up, Gopher Dunes, Troy Lee Designs, bam, another one in the books.
Passiotti hole shots and wins wire to wire, right?
Thanks, Trav, to the Yamaha leaderboard. Another solid moto for Teddy Mayer. Chisholm never says give up. Bobby Kay from his stall works up to 7th. Keystone there, Bless, and Dylan Kalen round out the top 10.
I'm sure at this point in time in the season, it's probably good for your confidence to flat out beat Mike Alessi on a track without a grip coming off or without some sort of bike issue. I know that means a lot to you.
Yeah, those guys were riding well out there. They were keeping me on my toes up front out there. I was making some mistakes, getting all sideways, and the track was pretty gnarly out there, second moto, and fans were great. So yeah, it was good end to the day.
It's a frustrating situation for a lot of fans that really wanted to see you guys open up today. I think the weather conditions kind of stymied the track and a little bit of maybe some battling that we could have seen in that second moto.
I definitely agree. It was really one line, and it really favored a guy who got you know, a good start or was out front. So, we'll regroup and come back next week strong.
Nice job in the impound to the series points after 7 of 10. Fasciotti really starting to stretch it out. But look at Medaglia and Hill. They're tight. Chisholm ahead of his teammate Kalen, Berger, and Gasson round out the top 10. Don't forget to like the CMRC Facebook page and go to mxnationals.ca for all the news, gossip, and information on the series.
There's your top 3 on the day at MX1. You have been watching the 2014 Rockstar Energy Drink Motocross Nationals, brought to you by Motovan.com, the source for power sports parts and accessories. Special thanks to Ross Thompson and Ryan Gulp. For Mark Travers and Brian Koster, we'll see you next week on the East Coast. Let's have a lobster.